Hey guys, this is Bigspin and today I'm bringing you another Wild Rift video. Today we are going to talk about Ziggs. Ziggs, in my opinion, is one of the most hidden OP picks in the game and he's so much fun because he deals ridiculous amounts of damage. And in this video, I'm going to show you detailed how to solo carry with Ziggs even at Grandmaster Challenge level. If you enjoyed this video, I would be really glad about you giving me a thumbs up at this video and also leaving a cost-free subscription on this channel because then you're not gonna miss any other interesting Wild Rift video. And I'd say let's get right into it. Alright guys, so before we jump into the gameplay, let's first of all get kind of familiar with this champion. Ziggs is an AP champion, so he's played mostly at mid lane. Some people are playing him as a support, as an AP support, but that's only good as an organized team. So when you have four mates and are playing in a tournament, then you can often see Ziggs support because it really has its advantages. But overall, he's the safer choice and the more common choice in mid lane, especially when you're playing solo queue classic ranked mode. So, Ziggs is a really good champion because he can poke his opponents really well and keep him like in range, and he also deals a ton of damage at all games. It's really insane. Ziggs almost always has the highest damage in the game, as you will see in the gameplay later on, but let's move on to his ability. So his first ability is kind of his bread and butter ability, I'm gonna call it. So you have a bomb that you can place anywhere in this radius, and this bomb is gonna like jump two times, so till it explodes. So if it doesn't hit an opponent right away, it will jump and then hit an opponent at max range. So if I cast this bomb here, you're gonna see, okay, this dummy is still being hit. So this bomb also does a small area of effect damage, as you can see, so I can hit both dummies at the same time, which is really cool, obviously. And this bomb also scales really well with AP and is your bread and butter ability that deals most of your damage. So as a second ability, that's where it gets kind of interesting. It's like a detonation pack that you place on the ground and it detones after 4 seconds. So for 4 seconds, you can recast the ability to make it detonate directly. And if you are standing on this package, you are gonna jump into the direction of the small blue circle. As you can see, as I move, there's a blue circle around me, and that's the area that I jump to when the Dito pack explodes at the time that I press the button again. And also this applies to opponents. As you can see, I can also smash these dummies, but as you can also see, I'm smashed far more away than these dummies. But if you cast it on a mate, there will have nothing, so you can't like send your mates into the death. It's only applicable to you and your opponents. This is a really cool ability and also Ziggs' main escape move. It doesn't deal too much damage, but there's a thing about this ability. If you get a tower, an opponent tower, lower than 20% of life, you will be able to one-shot the tower with this ability. This is really cool in combination with the passive, where you deal like it's like an auto attack that deals way more damage. And as you can see, there's this yellow bar under Ziggs. So this bar shows when you can do this enhanced auto attack. So now, right now, the bar is red, so I can deal more damage with my auto attack. It also scales with your AP, so this is really cool. And this also deals double the damage to turrets. So this is why Ziggs is a really good tower shredder as well, in like comparison to many other AP carries. He can shred towers really, really well, and this is also why people play a support, because he can take down the first tower really quickly with his passive and combined with this thing that just shreds the tower under 20%. So this is about Ziggs' passive. And as you can also see, when I cast abilities, the cooldown, which is initially 12 seconds of this strong auto attack, is decreased by 4 seconds. So as I cast two abilities after doing the auto attack, as you can see, I cast one ability, I cast two abilities, and I basically almost have this auto attack ready again. So this is really cool to know that you can reduce the cooldown of this enhanced auto attack by casting spells just for shredding your towers. Then we got the third spell. As you might have seen already, it's like a minefield. I hope you call this way in English. You just place some bombs at the bottom, and then people like who are gonna walk through it are getting damaged by each bomb. The first bomb deals 100% of the damage, but each further bomb that people walk through only deals 40% of the base damage. So to avoid that, you can just one-shot people by this ability, which would be really stupid, but it also slows them, so it's really good to escape and also to chase opponents and also to like prevent ganks from evident, because people who are invisible obviously can still be trapped by these bombs and walk through them and then get damage and then basically get visible. So then you give your ult. This is also a really, really good ability 2D damage. As you can see, there are two circles. So the range of this ulti, first of all, is insane. When I walk to mid lane, you can see that this range, like, I can almost instantly go to Dragon or Baron. So this is a really good tool to steal objectives from your opponents, but also in the fight, because it does so much damage. It is insane. So the outer circle does 2/3 of the damage that the inner circle deals, and the inner circle scales with 105% of your AP. This means if you're full build, this ultimate ability is gonna deal insane amounts of damage. As you can see, I'm just going to cast it, and you can see that the travel time is really fast. Like, it's the faster the closer the target is. So if I cast this ult here, the bomb travels a bit faster, and also, as you can see, I deal not that much damage in the middle as I would do, not much damage at the outer side as I would do at the middle. This ability, as you will see in the gameplay really soon, is completely strong damage wise. I mean, it's not comparable to an Orianna ult, because Orianna ult, for example, has crowd control additionally, but for the raw damage, this ability is really one of the strongest in the game. And I'd say we're gonna jump straight into the items. For the items, I buy exactly this on six. Why do I buy these items? So first of all, Luton's Echo really, really scales with six kits. So his bomb triggers Luton's, obviously. So it's really good to poke champions with Luton's, because you not only got the ability damage of the first bomb, but you also really oftentimes have the Luton's effect, because you are a mobility champ, like, you are moving all the time, so you can, like, load your Luton's, your Discordic Echo, really, really fast. And this is why I go for Luton's. Also, mana is really important for Ziggs at the start, because, as I said, he's just spamming his first ability, so you definitely need that mana, and also ability haste is a really good addition to that. Then I'm gonna buy Liandry's. Even though it got nerfed several patches ago, this is still a great item for any AP carry. You get life, you get ability power, and you get those two passives that are both really strong on Ziggs. I mean, you're just in the fight for the long term. So in the team fights, you're just gonna try to long term survive, to deal damage over time on and consistently pressure your enemies. This is why Madness is a really good passive with Ziggs, and also Torment. As I said, for each bomb you're gonna hit on the enemy, it's complete 1% of his max health damage. So additional damage to Luton's and to the actual damage of your abilities. Really, really good scaling item with Ziggs. For boots, I'm gonna choose Ioni boots of Lucidity, and also Zhonya's Hourglass, which is really good, because, like, Ziggs is not that much of an escape champion, because he only has his flash and his second ability, which is not 100% reliable in all of the cases. So you're gonna buy Zhonya's, because Zhonya's or Stasis is a really good tool to make you, to reposition you, to be able for your team to cover you after 2.5 seconds. So these are the boots, and obviously cooldown boots, because we are reliable on our spells. Then we are gonna go for Rabadon's. Obviously, this is the key item. This is the third item you're gonna go for in almost any case, because this gives you huge power spike, increases your ability power overall by 40%, and also giving you 130 ability power flat. This is a really, really, really huge power spike. If you get this item, you're gonna bust everyone, I guarantee you, as you will see in the gameplay. Then you can either go for Void Staff, a fourth, because if you play against tanks who buy much magic resistance, you're gonna want to have this passive dissolve plus a 40% magic penetration, so you penetrate the magic resistance at a percentage and not flat, which is a really huge bonus that you need to shred tanks. And also then Affinity Orb, it's also really cool. You get move speed from it, and you get flat magic penetration this time. So this item is the fourth one you're gonna go for if you don't play against any tanks. And also the Inevitable Demise is also really good, because then you can deal even more damage with your abilities, and also your ult is gonna strike even better. Ziggs rune kit is where it gets kind of special in a way. We have, first of all, the keystone, that is Conqueror. Conqueror is a really, really huge advantage on Ziggs if you play him well, because it stacks over time. Your damage is gonna increase over time, and Ziggs is definitely a champion that can make use of Conqueror, because he's always going to spam his first ability, his bombs, and also dealing damage with his auto attack. So also adding a Conqueror stack to this keystone, and at the end he deals 7% bonus adaptive damage. So in this case, because he builds AP adaptive damage, transitions into AP damage to his opponents, because he's not melee, it's only 7%, but still, this is a really, really good keystone, in my opinion, the best for this. For the second rune, you might need to have some balls, because champion is not a rune that you should use when you are insecure with the champion, but when you are really experienced, it's the number one rune for this to go. Why champion? So the effect of champion is that you gain 10% damage against champions, which is an insane stat for a rune, but the downside is that you lose 5% each time you die, then the bonus disappears. So as soon as you are 2 times dead, as you like die twice in the game, this rune is basically no effect, it's useless. So this is a like high risk, high reward thing that you can take, and I love to take it, because as Ziggs, you're gonna stand in the backline anyway, you're gonna play a really safe laning phase, and you can deal damage from basically any position in the fight and in the lane. So you don't really need to go all in or to overextend and to take the risk of dying. You don't even need to dive people, because you can just delete them from like a 10 meters distance. It's really, in my opinion, the best rune for champion, for Ziggs is the champion rune. Other option would be like Brutal. Brutal is also really good. It gives you also good stats. But in my opinion, if you have some balls, if you feel confident with Ziggs, definitely take champion, because this is one of the perfect kits for this rune. Then I got regeneration, because it's basically just a mana regeneration thing that you're gonna need, especially in the early game when you are really mana hungry and trying to spam these or to outpoke the opponent. And also Sweet Tooth, like you can also try to think about a mana flow band. I think both options are really good, but Sweet Tooth gives you additional gold and also some sustain in the laning phase. So this is the rune set I'm going for. And now we are gonna go straight into a huge, 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 huge gameplay. All right, guys, in this game, we are up against Orianna. Orianna is one of the top tier meta picks for the mid lane right now. She is so strong, so versatile, but Ziggs, I think Ziggs can like keep up to her on a different level. He isn't too good in lane against her, because she can more reliably poke him than Ziggs can Orianna, because like Ziggs' first ability is an ability that you can dodge easily, but you can't really easily dodge Orianna's first ability as long as you are in her range. So it's like really, I think, the slight advantage to Orianna in this lane if she plays aggressively. But this Orianna, in my opinion, makes the mistake that she doesn't really force me to miss farm, or that she doesn't really zone me by from minions by just standing really up in front and just dodging my first abilities and hitting me with her combination of the first and her second ability. So this is really good. I realized quickly that she isn't like about to pressure me that hard, which is what we want as Ziggs in this laning, in this matchup. And I'm just gonna like farm. I'm trying to farm, trying my best to get all that minions. And we already get this first blood from Malphite to Garen, which is really good, obviously. Really comfortable early game situation for us. But as you can see, Ziggs is one of the one of the best champions to like shove a wave. So Ziggs can push and push and push these waves, because he has his first ability, which is on a really low cooldown, really low mana, and really huge damage to minions, and also the third ability, which basically does the same to minions. So both area damage abilities with huge damage output against minions, also against champs, but especially against minions, it's really good to have those abilities. And Orianna obviously has the same, so Orianna is also really good at clearing waves, but Ziggs can keep up with her, and by like clearing the waves as fast as possible, we also kind of try to avoid that Orianna roams. So we try to keep the wave kind of in the middle, because otherwise Orianna could just push, and now she has time to roam theoretically. So this is what we want to like avoid, that Orianna gets an advantage on other lanes while we are farming under the tower, because we can do this with Ziggs. We can just keep up the pressure, we can just push and make the wave even. So at this point we are going to go back. I thought that Orianna was back, so I pushed the wave to like make her miss her minions, and as you can see, we succeeded it. She misses 2 minions, but she wasn't even back. At this point, I noticed that she was at the scuttle. Why wasn't she back? I saw it at the items and also at her mana, so she didn't have full mana, which you would have had if you were base. So at this point, I know, okay, she has to go back at some point, so this is my advantage, because now I have already 2 items. I deal more damage than her, so I could theoretically fight her. And yeah, this is overall really good for us that we went back here and denied her some minions in the first place, but also tried to yeah, get these items that we can now utilize to just deal more damage. So now, yeah, she shoves in, so she looks like she's going to want to go back. And this is where we also try to, like, push the wave to make her miss minions again, because she has to go back at some point. And if she goes back now, she's probably going to miss some minions if we clear this wave again. So we can see that the game is really doing in our favor right now. So it's 5-1, which is really good. We haven't really had too much of an influence on this game. I mean, we are 0-0, so it's all, like, even at our lane. But this is fine. I mean, Orianna is, in my opinion, Orianna is late game champion, but Ziggs is also a champion that, like, has his power spike when he reaches his third item, so his Rabadons. That's where he becomes the poke monster, and he isn't really that 1v1 champ in the laning phase. So you don't have to worry if you don't get those 3 or 4 kills in the laning phase right away. It's all good, man. You are 6. You can unleash your potential in the team fight. So here, this is an interesting situation. There you can see what impact you can have with your ultimate ability. I just saw the Gregors, like, chasing the Garen. So I switch on the map to see the situation. And then I decide, okay, this Garen is low, so I can get at least an assist, if not even a kill, on that Garen, which boosts my gold, which boosts Gregor's gold, because he gets the kill, which is overall just really, really good. And I don't even have to move from my lane. So this ability is a huge comfort ability for Ziggs to get some free assists, free kills, free gank participation for, like, not giving up your mid lane, which is a really good combination, because at other champions, for example, Orianna can't do this. Orianna must move to the situation to assist her team. And this is a really situation that is really key in this game, because, as you can remember, we got the champion rune. So what we want to avoid, by far most important point in this game, is not dying too early on. Because we got the champion rune, we did those 10% damage, and we want those 10% damage to be dealt further on. So this point, at this point, it was kind of suspicious for me already, because, like, Eve, Evelyn, Orianna wouldn't stay if there wasn't someone around, if it wasn't a bait. Because at this level, no one stays with that low HP against Ziggs if there wasn't, like, a background thought, like a gank that she would bait for. So I see Eve, and at this moment, at least already as Eve comes, as I see her, I know, okay, this is going to be my flash. Why? Because as soon as Eve is, like, at me, I can't really escape her, so I have to use my flash instantly, because I also burned my second ability. So this is really key to flash here. And as you can see, quite fortunate for me, Orianna also uses her ultimate, so this flash was double the value. Orianna doesn't have her ultimate anymore for the dragon fight, and obviously we don't have flash anymore, but it's a worth trade for not dying. And now we can easily get the Drake, I guess, because we are 4 people at the Drake. Garen is down, so they are, like, only up to 4 people. And Orianna and Eve don't even try to steal, so this is also really good. Eve could have jumped in, but she didn't. So this was a free Drake. And also, like, as you know, the Infernal Drake is, in my opinion, the most important Drake. And here, I missed the minion, which broke my heart. I was dead inside for a second for missing that Ken minion, but it's all good. We are, like, 8-3, so the situation is really good. And here, again, let's see. So I am in the middle. I walked, like, 3 seconds from the middle to the top lane. So this is where this ultimate gets insane. Insane damage, insane range, and let's see what this does, guys. Let's see. We ultimate these both guys. As you can see, we get the kill on the Misfortune, and of course, Blitzcrank is also dying from Gregor. So 1 free kill and front 3 assists for, like, 5 seconds of not staying in the lane. And this is so good. This boosts us by so much in this game, guys. You can't believe it. We just got, like, 450 gold and bunch of experience for moving, like, 3 meters into the river and not losing any farm. This shows how insane this ultimate is if you use it correctly, and more importantly, if you also have map awareness. Because in this situation, if we weren't aware of the situation that there were people, like, fighting at the upper lane, at the dragon lane, this ultimate would never have come into our mind. So as Ziggs, you have to constantly watch out for, like, opportunities to throw your ult at someone that you can assist. For example, we have 3 kill participations, so 1 kill and 2 assists, and all these kill participations result from an ultimate that we have thrown. We have dealt no other damage to these people, but just our ultimate, and this secured us so much gold and experience lead already. So here we shoved the wave, so we have really much gold as a mid laner. I thought I would, I wanted to go back at the first place, but then I got a little bit greedy. I don't recommend you to do this. I wanted to, not go back until I have my Lyandris. So what I do here is trying to get turret platings. As you can see, I use my first enhanced auto attack by my passive to damage the tower by a bunch. And then I try to use my two of my abilities to reduce the cooldown of my passive to get another enhanced auto attack on the turret to get the second plating. And that's what we also got here. So we got a bunch of extra gold. And as you can see here, we are just about to get Lyandris, which is really, really good. Like, I think we're going to need another 100 gold for it, but now here at the Herald fight, that's quite unfortunate for us. I don't know why our team went for the Herald here, but we can still like deal some damage, and I thought I could manage to save my Malphite here, but it wasn't the case, unfortunately. So now we can go back anyway and buy us Lyandris, which is a really, really good item. I mean, we got two items at the point of 7.35, and this is where we come, where we just deal so much damage that we can basically solo carry this game. So as you can see, earlier on we were 5-1 in this game, so we had a really good early game. But then we kind of start sucking right now. So it's 11-8. And I mean, as you can see, it's like we got 6 kills in this time. The opponents got 7 kills. So these guys are catching up slowly, and we obviously want to bring us back into the game, so we are gonna stay defensively. I collect more and more gold, which is, as I said, not a thing that I would recommend you. I'm just being greedy here. I must admit it, I'm just being greedy here because I want to have the satisfaction of just buying a full item. It's not rational. It's not the best decision I could have made, but as you can see, it turns out to be, yeah, to be okay. I mean, you're taking the risk of being ganked and not dealing enough damage with that much gold on the bank. But as you can see, it turns out to work quite well for us. And also, we got a huge gold advantage towards Orianna right now. So that's the point where we deal tons of damage already. Even though we don't have Rabadon's death cap ready, you can see what this one bomb of us does. I mean, Orianna is also dealing huge damage. She outtrade us at that point. But now the situation is quite critical, I'd say, because like Lulu died and the Drake is up, so we definitely want to make secure the Drake, so we don't want them to take the Drake. So we still stay, we don't go back even though we are low on HP. So in this situation, it's really good. We escape, as you can see. Okay, let's quickly recover this. So here you can see, okay, I'm half-life, so I'm taking a risk that I get dived by Garen or Eve, but I definitely want them to not take this dragon, because dragons are so important that I have to like show my presence to be physically in the situation and to poke these people to make them not take the dragon. So this is the point that I like my heart is racing right now, basically, because I know, okay, this heart is at me. Eve is coming, Garen is coming, Orianna is near, as you can see on the minimap. So in this situation, I definitely know, okay, I'm going to place my second ability in a way that I can escape, that I can also hit Eve to get a longer distance between us. So as you can see, this is what I also do. I jump over the wall, which is really good. Eve dives into three people. She thought she had me safe. She thought this was a safe kill, but it wasn't, because I reacted really fast, seeing Eve, and also almost immediately casting my second ability. This is really important. I would recommend you, if you aren't able to really cast or aim your second ability, you should definitely try it in some practice games. Practice it, go into the practice mode, practice it, cast this ability nearby you, and then instantly cast to jump. Practice this jump, because this is your only escape tool. So this is really important in my opinion. As you can see, it is a kill. It was also a good Orianna ult, but look at this ultimate from us. It was really good again. Bunch of damage to the opponents, as you can see. Garen is almost dead. Garen dies off to Gragas now, and this is where things get really interesting. My heart was racing at this point, guys. I was almost killed by Orianna, but Orianna acid, what, look at this, I was like, what the hell is happening in this game as I played it? Like, my heart was racing already because of Orianna almost killing me, and Eve almost killing me in the first place. But then, look at this bomb, guys, look at this bomb. This is like the thing that happens in one of like 20-30 games maybe. We just throws bomb, and the bomb literally just jumps over Orianna so we don't kill her. I was like, oh my god, this is not real right now. But fortunately, as you can see, we managed to hit this bomb, so there we get the kill and 420 gold, which is really, really good. We are 204 right now, so we still got the full champion rune bonus. We still got the full 10% of damage, which is so damn important. And now we're gonna go for even more damage. Why do we go for even more damage? Because I know, okay, our ultimate is up in 20 seconds, and I don't really need that cooldown boots and that Zhonya's in this fight, I guess, because I still have my flash up, so I can live without boots in the first place, and instead I'm going to go for more AP. And as you can see, it turns out to be the right decision, because Eve is already half-life after like one bomb, which is like, it's hilarious. It's just hilarious. The champion of this damage, no, the damage of this champion is just hilarious. So what we are going to do here is walk up to the tower. As you can see, I'm just going to take it, as I said, 20% or less life at the turret so we can execute it. And here you can see I failed my ultimate, but Orianna is also failing her ultimate. We just get the kill because she underestimated our damage, and this is where our additional damage that we bought for 1.3k gold comes into play. So we 1v1 Orianna. Unfortunately, these guys get the Drake, and as you can see, it's still a good fight for us, because like all of a sudden Malphite is coming in, and we just try to almost get a kill, not quite manage to get a kill, but it's still all good. Quite unfortunate that these people managed to get the Drake, but as you can see, Eve my flash wasn't necessary at this point. I kind of panicked, but that's fine, because we got the kill, and this is the most important thing. So we are 404 now, and we are about to solo carry this game by our damage. As you can see, we 1v1 Orianna. We killed Ori now, so we killed Eve now, so this is like the perfect spot for us where we want to be. We still got our full champion rune bonus, so this is also a point that is so damn important, as I mentioned like a few times already. And our mid turret is still alive too, so we still have all these, or this, the most important turret in the game, basically in the early game. We got the tier 1 mid turret, and we already killed hers, so this is really good for us also. And we are level 12, we got a bunch of gold, so we are in a really huge gold lead against Orianna, which is also like really important, because we deal way more damage because we have way more items. I mean, it's obvious, I guess. But now in the mid game, we're just gonna try to set up something. I think I see the split screen dying, so we move back again, and also we always try to get some vision around the river. Even though it's an Evelynn, we are going to make sure that we don't get ganked by their Dragon Lane or by the Baron Lane by placing the right wards. And now we are roaming, because I see, okay, I can't really push into mid lane, because like, it's so far pushed that I would risk getting ganked by two or three people. So we just go for the kills, go for the side lanes. So now I decide to go for the Baron Lane, obviously, because like Garen is back and we are three people, so we can easily get that turret and get that gold, obviously. So this was the right decision here to say, okay, let's just go for a turret. Let's not chase anyone. Let's not look for kills. Just the turret. As you can see, we shred this turret really, really quickly with our passive ability and also with our second ability. So at this point, yeah, I was like baiting the Garen. I thought, okay, maybe my team is like seeing it and noticing it, and we can just kill him as he walks up to me. But it's all fine. We just go back, and here we can see, okay, Kai'Sa and Orianna trade even for each other, which is okay for us. And now we got those items. Now we got this Revenants, and Revenants is our power spike. I said, now we are going to deal so ridiculous amounts of damage. I mean, we are 21 to 15, but I wanted to demonstrate how much damage we deal with our ultimate just by randomly casting it on Evelynn or at Miss Fortune. And now you can see, look at this damage. This Miss Fortune is just like, she just blew up. She literally blew up. I mean, she didn't die, but we got three kills. And as you could see, MF, Miss Fortune, didn't have really another choice than just backing off from that fight after casting her ultimate, because she was so damn low. She got hit by the Senna, and you have seen how much damage this was. So this is what I talk about when I say that Ziggs is just one of the champions that deals so much damage later on in the game. It is just insane. So your ultimate, I recommend you to always get it and on as many people as possible in the fight. So if you're 2, 3, or even 4 people, it's completely fine already. And if you then hit their AD carry or the squishy jungler, or even their like squishy support or mid laner, it's all perfect. Yeah, it's all perfect. This ultimate just did so much damage. It can turn fights by itself. Because, as I said, it's not like a game-changing ultimate in a way like Orianna, that you just cast it and people are getting like thrown together in the mid and in the middle, and just this ultimate isn't such a game changer CC wise, but it's a game changer damage wise. That's what I basically wanted to say. So you got this huge damage that can just turn fights, that can allow your team to re-engage the fight, to just get the fight into another direction. As you can see here, also the ultimate, I don't even hit anyone with the center, but it's enough. It's just enough damage to make Miss Fortune and also, of course, Evelynn go completely back off. And now we have a good situation to just take the Drake, which we are about to do. I mean, these guys are pinging for Drake. We know that Evelynn is low. We know that Miss Fortune is also low, and Miss Fortune is probably going to back off, so this is really good for us. And here I'm just going to zone these guys. Here Orianna, here we catch Eve, and as you can see, Eve was like, okay, at this point Eve was like, okay, I'm gonna steal this. But now we are just throwing a bomb at her. I mean, I want to predict that Orianna is like going towards the fight, but as we hit Evelynn, she's instantly at 40% HP already, so she can't really do anything in this fight, because there's a Fat Gragas, there's a Kaiser. She's just gonna blow up in this fight instantly, because before she can do anything, so she has to decide, okay, screw it, man, I just go out again. So this is like really effective, showing how much damage this champion actually deals. We hit her another time, so we can ultimate here, and by this ultimate, as you can see, we didn't quite manage to get the kill, but the more important thing was that we made these people not escape. So there was, I think Kaiser was in the fight, so Miss Fortune was escaping from Kaiser, but even though we didn't hit anyone, we zoned them from walking their escape rune. So at the first time we got here Orianna. Orianna just had to walk towards Kaiser again, and also Eve, like, it was so close, but as you can see, I think you see what I mean, that we almost got two kills off this, just because we managed to deny their escape routes. And at this point, this was the only mistake I did in this game. So as you can see, while being in the air by your second ability, you are not able to, you are not like invulnerable or stuff, and you can still be hooked by Blitzcrank. And in this situation, I didn't respect it. So what I should have done here is just flashing, because I knew that Blitzcrank would hook me there. And yeah, obviously he did. I jumped, but he still like pulled me back, which is quite a ridiculous interaction, but it is the way it works. So this way, if we flashed earlier, we probably would have escaped, because we wouldn't have even been hooked. But this is a mistake that happens, I guess. This is my only mistake. This has been my only mistake in this game too. So it's not quite too bad, but obviously 5-1-5 is still a score that you can work with, even though we lost our first 5% of the champion wound. So now we are skipping a bit to make you see what we are going to do next. So in this fight, my team even managed to take out two of them, which is really good. So my team is also catching up right now. They are also really doing a really good job in this game right now. And also Orianna is like trying to do something here, but she can't really get access to this fight. She can't really get close, because like obviously there are four people at the Drake, so this is not possible. As you can see, gold wise we are still in a huge lead, and we are dealing so damn much damage. Kaiser is also doing a great job. She has so much gold. She has 11 kills. I mean, she also has 7 deaths, I must admit, but still, she's also one of the main carries in this game. I mean, it's her job as an AD carry, but you know what I mean. And now we are setting up for Drake. And yeah, I was like, okay, this guy might be around, so we are dealing quite much damage to him as well. And as you can see, yeah, he lost quite some HP already. And now we are just going to go for this Baron. Like, setting up Baron at this point is basically trying to get one or even two or even three inhibitor turrets. So at this point, when you get the Baron, you can always surely take out these important turrets for later in the game and close out the game in your favor. And this is like the point Garen just ends here. Garen just feeds the hell out of him. And look at this damage again, man. This Miss Fortune is like at 10% HP. She was almost full life, but we hit her in the center, so we just get the kill here easily. And As I said, many people that I see using Zix, they use the ultimate as like a kill stealing tool, but I think this is the wrong approach. You just want to use it to deal as much damage in the fight as possible. You don't have to use it like doing all the kills. You just have to use it to deal the damage, to deal as much damage as possible. So with your ultimate, just remember, you want to deal as much damage as possible. It doesn't matter if you get the kills. Just hit as many people as possible. Deal as much damage. This is the most important key factor with this ultimate. So now, we are going for Void Staff. Why are we going for Void Staff? I explained it to you earlier on. We got that Garen and that Blitzcrank in the opponent team, which both have magic resistance already. So we are going to try to make deal damage to them also. So we rely on the passive of Void Staff to deal damage to people that already bought magic resistance. But at this point, it doesn't matter anyway because we have such a huge lead. As you can see, I don't even like, man, look at this damage. Look at this damage. This champion is so ridiculous. Look at this damage. She is full life. She has 100% health. And now this ultimate doesn't even hit her in the inner circle. It hits her at the outer circle. And look at this damage. She is half life. Her HP are reduced by 50% by one ultimate, not even hitting for the whole damage. If we hit her in the middle, she would probably have been around like 25% HP, because in the middle it's like 1.5 more damage than any outer circle. And this is just ridiculous. I mean, even though it doesn't matter anyway, we finish anyway, this shows how ridiculously much damage you deal as Zix. It is just crazy, guys. And this game was complete dominance. We did die once, obviously. That was my mistake. I could have flashed, but otherwise, this game was mainly won because of Kaiser, but also because of me dealing so much damage. I have like games where I dealt like double the damage than the second most damage dealing guy in the whole game. So from the opponent's team and also from my team. And this damage, as you can see, Kaiser even did a bit more damage than us. But compared to Orianna, we did 35,000 damage. She only did 20,000 damage. So this shows how crazy this champion actually is. It is really insane. As you can also see, we tanked. We tanked the least damage because as I said, I didn't want to die. So you're gonna want to have this picture looking like similar to this, so most damage or really much damage, but also not too much damage tank, because you don't want to die. If you die, your champion rune is getting like getting ripped off. So this is how you want to play Zix. As I said, his advantages are insane damage with his ultimate, insane poke. You can just poke them from anywhere. He's an ultra annoying champion, extremely annoying champ to play against. He has a good laning phase. So this champion, one of my favorite champions right now in the game. So here we are, guys. This is the end of the video. If you liked it, then feel free to leave a like on the video to show me that you enjoyed this video, and also a cost-free subscription to this channel, which makes you not miss any more great of content. I try my best to give you the best high level gameplay and to explain you my thoughts, that you can get a better, that you can become a better player. So if you want to see more of these videos, feel free to subscribe and also recommend this channel to your friends. Would mean a lot to me. I will try to upload more regularly now, because as you can see, I also have a German channel where I upload 2 videos a day, and also I live stream daily on Twitch. So this is really hard for me, but I try my best. If you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and have a great day. We'll see us next time.